Hi, today I'll be doing a bright lip makeup tutorial for you. So starting out, I'm just going to apply this ModelCo Face Base Primer to my skin, and it's just going to help my foundation glide on smoothly and just moisturize my skin. There's a conclusion to my illusion, I assure you this. There's no end to this confusion. My foundation of choice today is the Loreal True Match Foundation, and I'm just applying that with my beauty blender. And I've applied quite a thin layer, but I've spent a lot of time really buffing it into my skin just to get a really flawless finish. It's really important to blend your foundation down your neck so that you get a seamless finish. So I'm just using my Kevin Aucoin Sensual Skin Enhancer for concealer, and I'm just applying that under my eyes, on my chin, a little bit on my nose, and a blemish on my forehead. For brows, lately I've been loving ModelCo's brow kit, and mainly because it has a wax in it which I'm applying directly to my brows just to set them in place, and then I'm just filling them in and following my natural shape, starting with a lighter colour at the beginning of the brow and then gradually moving into the darker shade. To keep your brows from looking too drawn on, it's important to comb them through as you go, just so they don't look too harsh. So here I'm just applying my Benefits Gimme Brow just to thicken them up a little bit and set them in place. To prevent your under eye concealer from creasing, you just want to set it in place with a setting powder, which I'm doing here with Bareminerals Well Rested Concealer and a Real Techniques setting brush. I want my skin to have a beautiful glow, but I don't want to appear like I'm oily, so I'm just applying a light dusting of mineral powder over my skin. I like to warm up the skin with Bourjois chocolate bronzer just in the cheekbone, temples area and around my jawline. For a nice defined cheekbone, I'm going in with HOOLA Benefit Bronzer and a MAC 109 sculpting brush. And I'm also applying that to my temples, down the sides of my nose, my jawline, and just underneath my bottom lip. Going in with a small duo fiber eyeshadow brush, I'm just applying a little bit more bronzer to the sides of my nose for a more defined finish. If you feel like things are looking a little harsh, you can take your big
fluffy powder brush and just really go over everything and buff everything out, and it'll just really soften the look. Highlighter is probably hands down one of my favorite products to use just for that really glowing skin effect. So I'm just applying it with the same MAC 109 brush to the high points of my cheekbones, down the bridge of my nose, my chin, Cupid's bow, and the high points of my forehead. For a healthy sheen to the cheeks, I love Max Factor's Miracle Touch Creamy Blush in the shade Soft Pink, and I'm just using a Real Techniques stippling brush to buff that onto my cheeks, and it just gives a gorgeous flush of colour without looking too overdone. Because the lip colour that I'm going to use today is super matte, I don't want my lips to be dry, so I'm just applying some pawpaw. Keeping the eyes really simple today, I'm using Max Pigment and Tan and applying it wet with Fix Plus, just all over the lid and blending it up into the crease. I'm just applying Bobbi Brown's eyeshadow and camel to the crease just to warm up the eye. This is the moment that I realised that I had completely missed out filming my eyeliner and my mascara, which, as you can see on my face, I'm not too impressed. Anyway, moving on, I'm just going to take those clips out, and then I'm using the Revlon Matte Balm in the colour Unapologetic. And I can't get enough of this lip shade. I just love it. If you read my blog, you'll know that I don't normally wear bright colours very often, but I can't get enough of this colour. I love it. So that is the finished look, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it and comment below your thoughts, and I'll see you in my next video.